Thank you. Thank you. It's such an honor to be here. God bless you. It's really hard for me to see all these people, you know, when they made this theater. And when you were in behind these bars and in these prisons, and when I just saw the people that they were playing this theater, I just called the name of the prisoners that I was living with them for years and years. You know, people like that they just been in prison for years for doing nothing, but just wants to do, saying their rights and their what they want to, just how they want to live. For the last 40 years, we have seen that freedom of press, freedom of religion, and freedom of speech has been abused. And we saw that today. I was imagining that we all heard about what ISIS is doing, what Al-Qaeda is doing to slaughtering people all around the world, not just in Syria or in Iraq, and how Iran government is kind of like doing things in Iraq. And just imagine after 30 years, like their leader, Abu Bakr Baghdadi, come to United Nations, and all the leader of the world, they shake his hand. What I see today is when President Rouhani comes, and with the history that we see that they slaughtered 30,000 people in just 3 months, and they just continue murdering people every day, every day, every day. When I was in Gardash prison, every Wednesday at 3 in the midnight, they took people for execution. We know that last month, thousand get execution and be killed for nothing. And we have, there is a list of like thousand other people that they want to execute in next months. So we are here to be a voice for the people that they don't have any voice. And we are here to just say to the world that if you close your eyes to the human rights in Iran, by removing sanction, by talking to the leaders and talking the agreements, still we stand with the victims, still we stand with people in prison, and we still are going to be a voice for them and say that you are alive in our heart, you are alive in our voice, and we are standing with you. Amen.
Amen.
Last years in Iran, we saw so many journalists, so many politicians, so many religious leaders, they went to prison, and they always just want to have a better Iran, better future, and they have been shut down. Some of them, they have been tortured to death. We saw people like Neda and Rehana that they got raped and killed in street. We saw people that like other men, like Ali Reza Sadi, that has been executed 1 month ago for nothing. And we are here to just say we want to stop any execution in Iran, and Iran government should listen to us. And I'm actually here to say even the UN, even US, and even EU, all of them, they need to just pay attention about this human rights in Iran, that we never forget these people, that they are standing for their rights and for freedom in Iran, and we're going to stand with them. And I have a message for you all, that God never forget victims. God always stand with the victims. And God, that who always see all the tears, see all the bloodsheds, and he never forget any cry. When I was watching all the people here, when watching the theater, I saw so many tears. God is watching it. God is seeing the broken hearts. He wore the flesh, a body, came on the earth, went on the cross that you see on the top of that church to pay the punishment of sin, which is death, that we can today, we can have a true relationship with him. And when we can call him for justice, he's going to action. He's going to do something, and he's going to punish the weak. It's the time that we see the punish of the weak. And I believe the God that we serve, he's going to listen. He's going to see. And nothing can stop his plan. God is in control of everything. He chooses everything. And he is the one that is going to do his justice. So when we have him, we're going to be victors. So we can celebrate our victory today. And we can see that in a future, we can see a brilliant future for Iran. And we're going to see, I'm here to celebrate the future for Iran. I don't pay attention to what's happening right now. I believe in future we're going to see an Iran that is going to be changed, and people are going to experience the freedom life that they are looking for and paying all this sacrifice. And I thank all of you that are standing with me here to be a voice for a people that they don't have any voice in the world. I just want to finish with a prayer. And every people in the Middle East that are going through all this hardship and all this hard time. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, I'm come to you in Jesus' name. And I believe that you hear us from the heaven right now. I pray that you just come and you do your will in our country, in Iran and everywhere. We pray for people that are in prison, that they get beaten every day and get tortured every day. And the people that they have, their name is in their execution name of the list of Iran government for next month. I believe that you can hear and you can save. I believe you are in control and you have an amazing plan for our country and you have an amazing plan for Iran. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. Yeah.